Hello again. In this part of the course, we will go in depth with the asset sections here. The asset section here include three components that includes asset editor, appearance manager, and Gauss Cosmos. If I click here on the asset editor, you can see that I have some materials here, but these materials were imported from the Cosmos, which is the Gauss Cosmos. So now material will be not downloaded with the V-Ray. It will be in Cosmos library and you will download it. So if you haven't here anything, don't worry, you can go and browse material in Cosmos, and this is what is called Gauss Cosmos. Let's have a look on Gauss Cosmos first and then return back to the material asset. If I expand this, and let's see what here in the left side, we have the three models, we have materials, we have HDRI, which are related to the background and the lighting of the background, and the collections and creators. So you can now download anything about three models, which are included furniture, accessories, lighting, vegetations, vehicles, people, animal, architecture, and anything you want. And every component of this, if I expand it, you can see much more options that you can download. Also for the material, the same idea here. So I have, for example, here break. If I click on break, you can see a lot of breaks. So you have to download what you need. In fact, I download most of things, so you have the opportunity to download all the assets to your asset manager or the asset editor here. So in that case, you can have all the assets here from the Gauss Cosmos, but you can download what you need also. So if you need, for example, a material, for example, a concrete material, you can go to Cosmos and then to concrete, and then you can download. Once it was downloaded, you can click here and you have the opportunity to use the mapping, or you can click to off it. But if you need to map it, you can click here on the on button, and then you can import. Once imported, it will automatically go to the V-Ray asset, and the V-Ray asset editor will open automatically here. So this is the idea behind the Gauss Cosmos. Now let's have a look on this 3D view, and let's say that we want a tree here or some side component here. So we can go to Cosmos. Let's say this is the Cosmos, and we can go to 3D model. We can go also to vegetation, and under vegetation we have trees, indoor plants, shrubs, bushes, and flowers. So I want the trees. You can also download, if it's not downloaded, you can search what you want. I have downloaded one. Now maybe under here we can see what it was. I think I have one downloaded. So if you see something that you are interested in it, you can download it. Let's download some tree here, for example this one. So it will start now downloading this tree. After download, it will automatically reflect it to the 3D view that you have. So as you see, import here. We are waiting now, so it will direct us to the 3D view that we are working on. So as you see here, it said to me that assets progress is in progress. So you can place it anywhere you want in your 3D view or in your plan, as you want, according to the view that you have. So let's have a look about these components. Click escape twice to have these. So I bought some trees here in my view. Let's render interactive render and see the changes on our 3D view. So as you see here, it will start now rendering our shots.